So dear students, we have rigorously completed the two main phylum of Animalia kingdom. First is Porifera, then Cylinderella. And today we will discuss much more regarding to the third phylum under subkingdom Invertebrata, which remains under kingdom Animalia. Are you all ready for that?
Yes, sir.
Now look at the platelminthes. And if you look the platelminthes, you can see that the platelminthes is comprises of two Greek word. One is platy, that means plot, and helmin, that means worm. Okay, look towards here.
Platy helmins get their name from two Greek words, platy meaning flat, and helmins meaning worms. The phylum Platyhelminths includes tapeworm and liver fluke.
This is two example you can see here. Two example, one is tapeworm, another one is liver fluke. Generally, liver fluke is present in case of pig, and tapeworm is found in human being. And such type of animals, if you observe, their dorsal side means back side and ventral side means the belly side, they both are flat in surface appearance. Okay. And they are called as flatworm. Look.
Platyhelminths are either free living or parasitic.
Planaria is another example of platyhelminths. Sometimes they are free living in nature, that means they do not open any other living organism for their nutrient purpose. But some are parasitic, which remains present in other animals for their nutrient purpose. That means they live in the animal which they can infect. Okay.
Free living animals include planaria, and parasitic animals include liver flukes.
Remember the examples also. Okay.
Their bodies are dorsoventrally flat and ribbon-like, and they are hence called flatworms.
The body is flat, dorsiventrally flat ones. Understand the word. Dorsal side and ventral side is flat in appearance. So it is called as they have the dorsiventral ribbon-like body. Ribbon means tape-like body. Okay. Now look at here.
Their bodies are bilateral.
Caught them at the middle. You can see that if their left side is similar to the right side, hence their two lateral sides are symmetric to each other. So you are seeing two lateral side, such type of symmetry is called as bilateral symmetrical body. Okay, such animals have bilateral symmetrical body.
Truly symmetrical, meaning that the left and the right halves of the bodies have the same design.
Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now look.
Yes, sir.
Their bodies have three layers of cells that.
Now your what basis of body cavity come in play? You can see here. We have to consider the body cavity whether it is present or not. And if you see the, if you cut the flatworm like this way, you can see that their body has such a structure that develops from three distinct germ layer. One is ectoderm, another is endoderm, then in between these two derm, these two layer is your mesoderm. Okay.
Yes,
and these three layers develop their respective organs during the course of development. All the internal organs are present in the mesoderm layer.
Formed.
And later on, body cavity develops. But here you can see that these animals, though they have, this animal has three germ layer during this, during its embryonic stage, but it doesn't develop the body cavity or coelom inside it. So such type of animals are called as acoelomates. Means absent of coelom, no coelom.
Differentiated tissue.
Revise it.
This is why they are called triploblastic animals.
Look at here, why they are called as triploblastic animal? Because they have three germ layer, triple germ layer during their gastrula stage. and gastrula stage comes after blastula stage. Yes or no? During the embryo development stage, you have learned. After blastula stage, you have your gastrula stage. And during gastrula stage, the embryo develops three germ layer, primary germ layer, from which the rest all body parts develop. Could you understand? Though they have three germ layer in their embryonic stage, they are called as triploblastic animal. Remember. Could you understand why they are called as triploblastic? They have triple germ layer, okay, during their embryonic stage. Is it clear to everyone? Hello?
Yes.
And those have only ectoderm and endoderm. They have only two germ layer and previous two phylum. Okay, generally they have only two germ layer during their embryonic development. Especially in case of platelminthes, you can see, sorry, cylindrata, you can see, sorry, one individual is there, one intermediate phylum is there in between cylindrata and platelminthes. If you want to see, look at here. One intermediate phylum remains in between cylindrata and platelminthes, that is called as tenophora, C-T-E-N-O-P-H-O-R-O. Tenophora contains, sorry, if you want to know simple, a little bit about tenophora, the jellyfishes remains under tenophora phylum, okay, and they are diploblastic in nature, means they have two germ layer during the embryonic stage of development. And from tenophora, what about the rest all animals are there? They have three germ layers during their embryonic development. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
In between cylindrata and platelminthes, one phylum is there known as tenophora that contains jellyfish like structures or animals. Jellyfish also remains under tenophora. Okay. They have what? Sting cells. Remember, and sometimes they bear the bioluminescence materials in it. So today I have started the class from that video, that why animals have the bioluminescence capacity, to get some idea regarding to what tenophora. Okay, now come to our point of discussion, that platelminthes, they are what? Triploblastic in nature. Is it clear to everyone why they are called as triploblastic? Is it clear?
Yes,
because they have three germ layer during the embryonic stage of development. Now look.
Flat worms have no body cavity.
Yes, because the no gap you are seeing presenting in between mesoderm.
It's called acylomates.
They are called as acylomates. Do not follow this spelling. Acylom, look at here. Acylom. And if you say they have that, what is their body type? You can say they have the acylomate body type, or they are acylomate.
They lack respiratory.
And they do not have respiratory system. They do not have respiratory system, and they do not have lungs. They do not have the windpipe. They do not have circulatory system, and they do not have heart, blood vessel, blood. Okay.
And circulatory systems.
Now concludes the next point of discussion, that is nematoda. Look at here, few characters, they are common in all the organisms. Gradually we are seeing the common characteristics of animalia kingdom in all the phylum. But some special characteristics we are discussing here. Is it clear to everyone? And gradually we are seeing that some type of modification are developing in between the animals when we are moving from one phylum to another phylum. Gradually they are developing, okay? Now
nematoda get their name from two Greek words, nema, which means thread, and ode, which means life.
Look at here. This nematoda comes from two Greek words. One is nema, nema means thread, and one is oda, that means life. But I have said nematoda has another name. They are called as aschelminthes, or sometimes they are called as nemathelminthes. So remember, nemant means round and helminth means worm. Though they are cylindrical body, rounded shaped body, we can say such worms as they are the round worms. Platelminthes, they con this phylum contains flatworms, and nematoda or nemanthelminthes contains roundworm. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now let us see what are the special characteristics that they are, whether they are triploblastic or not. They will be triploblastic, okay, because they are much more advanced than the platyhelminthes. Look at your
The phylum Nematoda includes Ascaris, Enterobius, and Wuchereria.
Look at here. These are the examples of roundworms or Nematoda. What are these? Ascaris, Enterobius, Wuchereria. We have to pronounce it as Wuchereria. Okay. But the spelling should be Wuchereria. But you have to pronounce it as Wuchereria. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
These are the examples, remember, with the beautiful diagrams.
Now, nematodes can be
like our flatworms. Some roundworms, they are free living, that means they do not live inside any living or any other living organism, but some are parasitic, means they remain inside the living organism and infect them. You can see
free living or parasitic. Parasitic worms in humans are roundworms and pinworms in the intestine of humans.
You can see in case of human being, we can see just one type of rounded worm is there. Its common name is roundworm. And one pin-shaped worm is there. Its common name is what? Pinworm. Pin, you know, the needle-like worm. They are present in where? In the small intestine as well as large intestine of human being. In the large intestine, you can see roundworms are there. In small intestine, if you have any infection, pinworms will develop out there. Okay, they will live there as parasite. They will extract the nutrient from your body. Okay, you may have seen such type of worms, they are present in a stool also. And one worm known as filarial worm, it can cause elephantiasis disease. Means commonly you can say it is the filaria disease due to the infection of filarial worm, and it increases the size of your limb. Okay, limb means leg or hand. It increases the size of limb and causes the disease elephantiasis, remember, and that is caused by filarial worm.
Filarial worms in lymph and limbs cause elephantiasis.
Look at here, and you can write also filarial worms can cause the disease elephantiasis. That means it can increase the size of your limb. Okay, have you ever seen such type of diseased person?
Yes, sir.
That is because of what? This filarial worm, one kind of nematoda. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Very good.
Their bodies are long and cylindrical.
Now you can see their body is long as well as
showing bilateral symmetry.
And this ascaris is present in human being, okay, roundworm. And they show the bilateral symmetry, means if you split them at the middle, you can see the left half will be equal to the or symmetrical to the right half. Though their left side and right side are equal to each other, we can say such type of symmetric body as they have the bilateral symmetric body or symmetrically bilateral body they have.
Nematodes are triploblastic.
Now look at here, their body layer, germ layer found during their embryonic development. They also are triploblastic, means they have three germ layers during the course of their embryonic development. What are these? One is ectoderm, inner endoderm, and middle mesoderm. And mesoderm is represented here in pink color. Here you can see.
Their body cavity is pseudocoelom.
And if you see much more efficiently, you can see that inner to their mesoderm, outer yellow line is your ectoderm. This body covering is made up of ectoderm, and this tissue filled region, you can see this orange color region, this is a tissue filled region. This is made up of mesoderm, or that develops from mesoderm, and inner to that region you have a fluid region, simply normal fluid region, okay, that present around the digestive tract, which develops from endoderm, okay. And this normal fluid filled region is represents as the false cavity, and hence it is called as pseudoxylem. Though the cavity like structure is present, but it is not present in between two mesodermal development layer, hence it is called as pseudoxylem. I have already discussed this thing, yes or no? Do you have any doubt? Is it audible to everyone? Okay, very good. Now look at here. So hence you can say them as they are pseudoxylomate in nature.
They also lack respiratory and
circulatory. Also they do not have respiratory system. That means they do not have lungs, windpipe, etc. They do not have circulatory system, means they do not have a heart, blood vessel, means blood pipe, etc. in their body. Now what's the next phylum?
Annelida.
That is the annelida. Okay. Consider that this one is your earthworm. It is the best example of your annelida. Or what is the example? Let us see.
Get their name from the Latin word annelus.
Okay, annelida comes from the Latin word annulus. Annulus means little ring. Yes. What's the problem? Look at here. You can take the screenshot if you can. So annelida comes from the Latin word annulus, that means little ring. And if you see properly, their body is arranging like the arrangement of a chain of little rings. Yes or no? There are different segmented parts are there. But they are not truly segmented. Look at here.
Which means
then you have to consider our third criteria, but first of all we have to cover our coelom, the criteria upon coelom, whether the body will possess or not. Yes. Look at here.
Little ring. The
phylum. Mute yourself, all of you. Mute yourself, otherwise the sound will be for all of you. Mute yourself.
Sir.
Yes.
Doubt.
Ask.
Sir, pseudoxylem means?
Pseudoxylem. Pseudo means false.
Yes, sir.
In case of pseudopodia, we have learned in case of alloimus, amoeba, that pseudo means false and podia means fit. And here, pseudo means false, whereas coelom means body cavity. Though their body do not bear truly body cavity or truly developed body cavity, we can say such type of body cavity animal as such type of body cavity containing animal as they are pseudoxylomate, and their false body cavity is called as pseudoxylem. And why? Though the cavity like structure is present, but we are not saying it as the proper coelom, because this cavity is not enclosed within the mesoderm. Okay, if the cavity will remain in between the mesoderm layer, then we will say the this is the true coelom. And in case of this phylum that you are seeing, the annelida, you can get proper coelom. And how proper coelom is present, means proper body cavity is present in between the mesodermal development region, you just have to see. Look at here, you can understand where true coelom is there. Then you can understand why I am saying that was the pseudoxylem or false coelom. Okay. Is it clear, Deva? Hello. Is it audible?
Yes,
okay, fine.
Yes.
Now look at the example of annelids. Okay.
Includes earthworms and leeches.
Okay, earthworms and leeches, these are the common example of annelids. And generally they prefer to live in dumpy area. Okay.
Annelida are found in a variety of habitats. Freshwater, salt water, as well as on land.
Means where the water as well as land mixture is there. They are majorly found at this condition when moist soil should be there. The earthworm and leaves like structures they develop are there, and they are even fresh water living animals. Some animals are there. They are what? Marine water living animals. So here we have only two examples regarding to that. One is your what? Earthworm, and another one is your leaves. Now look towards here.
Their bodies are bilaterally symmetrical.
Their bodies bilaterally symmetrical means if you split them at middle, you can see that left side and right side, they are similar to each other. So they are also similar to the previous phylum, three phylum that we have seen. They have bilateral body symmetry. Again, I want to recall. Again, I want to remember you all. Look at here. That porifera, they have asymmetric body. Cylindra, they have radial symmetric body. Plateal means nematoda and annelida, they have bilaterally symmetric body. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now look at here.
The organs of annelida are differentiated in a segmental fashion, and the segments are lined from head to tail.
If you see that the parts of annelida body, they are arranged in segmented pattern. Number of segments are there, which provide them the ring-like appearance. Yes or no? From head to their tail, they have such segmented part. Okay, but they are not truly separated from each other. Each segment is not truly separated from each other. From outer side, they have a little bit groove that provides them the segmented body structure. Okay, and all the respective organs remains in different segmented parts. Look at here. You will see their body cavity. See their germ layer during embryonic development. They also have three germ layer. Hence, we can see them that they are triploblastic. Means annelids are triploblastic. Look at here. The group is called as annelida. The phylum is called as annelida, and their members are called as annelids. Okay, and why they are called as triploblastic? Because they have three germ layers during their embryonic development, and later on different parts of their body develop from these three basic germ layers.
Triploblastic animals.
Now look at the body
have
cavity.
A true body cavity called coelom.
If you see here that they have the true body cavity like structure is present in between the mesoderm. That means when mesoderm is splitting, it is forming one gap that is called as body cavity or coelom, which is remaining in between the mesoderm layer. Okay, though their coelom is remaining enclosed within the mesodermal development structure or developmental region. Look at here, this pink color layer has developed from the mesoderm. And though the body cavity is developing in between the mesoderm, hence we can say such type of body cavity as true body cavity. And the organism which contains truly developed body cavity, such organisms are called as coelomate. Okay.
Now look at the body structure. Annelids are characterized by the presence of a circulatory system.
Now you can see that from annelida, your circulatory system has developed. Means the blood can flow throughout their body. Okay, if you want to see, you can see here that the blood can flow the vessels present in their body. But how their blood will look, we just have to see wait for a moment. Look at here. Generally, they have what very similar structure, what blood like structures are there in their body. Okay. Which is not red, and some animals of them, they depends upon the human blood, like your leaves depends upon the animal blood also for its nutrient purpose. Now come towards the next point of discussion regarding to the next phylum known as Arthropoda. Arthropoda is comprised of two Greek words. Let us see what are these. Arthro means jointed and poda means leg. But you have to see, look at here.
Arthropoda means joint legs. This phylum gets its name from the Greek words arthron, meaning joint, and podus, which means foot.
Understood, everybody? So arthropoda comes from two Greek words. One is arthron, that means jointed, and poda means. Poda comes from another Greek word, that is podos, that means foot. Okay, though they have jointed leg, actually they have jointed leg part, foot is the part of leg, so they have the jointed leg, hence we can call such type of animals.
They're not audible.
Is it audible to rest of students?
Yes, sir.
So come to the net version, beta. If you have any problem, then come to the net version. Probably the slow network is causing fluctuation in your sound. Look towards here. Though all the animals have jointed legs, which are remaining under arthropoda, I can say that these animals are arthropods. Okay, majorly all the insects are present in arthropoda phylum. And remember, one special characteristic or special fact regarding to arthropoda is that arthropoda is the largest phylum of Animalia kingdom, because it contains the largest varieties of animals as well as number of animals found on earth. Look at here.
The phylum Arthropoda includes honeybees, spiders, prawns, and centipedes.
These are the examples of some arthropods. Okay. And if you observe their leg, you can easily say that they are jointed in nature. Yes or no?
Arthropoda is the largest phylum with 800,000 different kinds of insects.
Okay, now understood. What is the fact? It has 80,000 different kinds of insects, and that constitutes nearly about 80%. What number of total animal which have categorized under Animalia kingdom? Okay.
80% of the animal kingdom is included within this phylum.
So that it is called as the largest phylum.
Their bodies are bilaterally symmetrical and...
Understood why they are bilaterally symmetrical in nature? Because if you split their body into two halves, you can see that the left half is just similar to right half. Though they are showing such type of body, you can say that their body is bilaterally symmetrical. Is it clear?
Segmented.
Or you can say their body have bilaterally symmetric. Okay. Now look
towards
their germ layer.
Arthropoda are triploblastic animals.
During their embryonic development, they also have three germ layers like the previous four phylum. And hence they are called as previous three phylum, Platyhelminthes, Nematoda, and the, they all are triploblastic. Now your arthropoda is also triploblastic, because and one is your what, Ctenophora, it is what, diploblastic in nature, remember. Coelenterata is also diploblastic in nature, remember. And look at here, that triploblastic, why they are called? Because during their embryonic development, which animals undergoes embryonic development, only they can develop the germ layer. Okay, so during the germ layer embryonic development, the arthropods possesses three germ layer. One is ectoderm and endoderm, mesoderm. And here also you can see that one cavity is present in between the mesodermal development structure. That is the true coelom. Hence, the animal is also called as coelomate in nature. That means from Annelida, you can see the truly developed coelom present in the animal. And hence, you can say them, they are what? Coelomate. Nematoda is your pseudocoelomate. Platyhelminthes is the acoelomate. Remember. And in Coelenterata, only two germ layer is there. And Ctenophora, it also has two germ layer there. Mesoderm is not there. Hence, they will not possess coelom. Now come to our point of discussion regarding to arthropoda, why it is triploblastic and coelomate. Look at here.
With a true coelom, these insects breathe through their trachea.
Okay. These insects have spiracles. in the both side of their body you have learnt in standard 7, yes or no? Insects can respire through the spiracles and tracheal system present throughout their body. Tracheal system means wind tube system present throughout their body. That means from this arthropoda, the respiratory system has developed. From annelida, circulatory system has developed. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Remember also.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Remember also. And arthropoda also will possess the circulatory system. Means in arthropoda, both circulatory as well as respiratory system is also present.
Their circulatory system is open, so the blood does not flow through blood vessels.
Now look towards the circulatory system. If you see the circulatory system structure, they do not have a blood vessel, means blood pipe. And generally our blood circulates through the pipes or through the blood vessels, and vessels when later on splits or branches into capillary, still the blood can passes through it. But in case of this arthropoda, there each and every cell is filled up with the body fluid, okay, or the blood, which is called as hemolymph. Look at here, the blood of the arthropoda is called as hemolymph, okay, H-A-E-M-O-L-Y-M-P-H, hemolymph, and that circulates openly without circulating inside the blood vessel. And hence this type of circulatory system is called as open circulatory system, means the blood can directly reach to the cell without passing through the blood vessel. But in case of us, we have closed circulatory system, means the blood moves inside the blood vessel. But in case of such animal, the blood moves, but it doesn't need any blood vessel to flow. All the body parts
directly
or body tissue, it remains submerged under the body fluid or hemolymph. Okay, and such type of circulatory system is called as what? Open circulatory system. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Means this type of circulatory system is not developed. This type of non-developed circulatory system is present in arthropoda. It also contains respiratory system, having spiracles and tracheal system to track, to transport or to exchange the air. Look at your next.
The coelomic cavity is filled with blood.
And whatever the body cavity is present in case of such animal, if you see, the coelomic cavity is filled up with what? That's blood. Okay.
So the blood does not flow through blood vessels. The coelomic cavity is filled with blood.
And that blood is called as hemolymph for this case, remember. Now comes to the next phylum, Mollusca. Okay.
Mollusca is derived from Latin.
And this one is the word only derived from Latin. Okay, not from Greek word. All the rest words are derived from Greek word, but only Mollusca. It derived from the Latin word. Look at here, what is that?
It means thin shelled and soft.
It has what? A thin shell and a soft body, inner soft body, outer thin shell. SHELL means what? Covering. Made up of, majorly made up of calcium. They have the outer hard thin shell and inner soft muscular body mass. Hence they are called as mollusca. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
They have very soft body, and for their protection they have only a thin calcareous structure is present around them. Okay, hence they are called as mollusca. Soft body mass covered by thin shell. Look at here. This one is the main characteristic.
Phylum Mollusca includes chitin, mussel, snail and octopus.
Look at here, these are the animals which you can categorize under phylum Mollusca. And your mollusca generally contains such animals which can found in freshwater region as well as marine water condition also. Yes or no? And octopus is the very most interesting animal that you have seen. These are the different examples of what? Mollusca. You can take the screenshot to remember these all. And also you have to write to practice it. Look at your...
Mollusks are aquatic in habitat.
They are aquatic means they are living in water. That might be freshwater, that might be marine water also. You will see
their
body
are soft. And
if you core them, you will see that their body is soft in nature.
Comprise head, visceral mass and foot.
Three distinct part of this animal, you just have to remember. This is what? One is anterior head and posterior visceral body and ventral post muscular foot is there. Anterior means at the top part. Posterior means at the last part or tail part. And ventral means belly side. Dorsally, okay, here it will be the dorsal side. Dorsally they have a ventral mass. Dorsal means what? Back side. Where your vertebral column is present. And belly means ventral side. So ventrally they have muscular foot. Dorsally they have visceral mass. And anteriorly means at the top they have the head. Okay, top means at the front position. Anterior means front position. Okay. Top frontal position is called as the anterior position. So these are the three distinct part of mollusk. Write down. This is the anterior head, then your dorsal visceral mass and ventral muscular foot. And is covered by the
locomotion muscle. In mollusks is by means of a muscular foot.
Yes, in case of such animal, they can move, they can locomote from one place to another place by the help of foot. And sometimes they secrete the slippery substances from their foot that makes the mark. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Their bodies are enclosed in a hard calcareous shell.
Yes, this is the main point. Their body, they have the soft inner body. To protect it, they have a hard calcareous shell. Means it is made up of calcium. Okay. S-H-E-L-L, cell, not C-L-L. Cell means covering here.
Their bodies are bilaterally symmetrical.
Yes, it will split their body into two halves. They have the left half and right half with equal symmetry. And such type of body is called as bilaterally symmetrical body. Clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And less segmented.
Less segmented means in case of previous phylum, in Annelida, you have seen they have ring-like structure, segment-like body structure. But here, you cannot see such type of more in number of segmentation. Nearly about 3 to 4 segments you can see in case of snail. Yes or no? You will observe their cell. If you observe their cell in case of, if you see, look at here. In case of snail, you can see one segment, another segment, another segment. And in case of such chiton, you can see few segment is there. But not like the more segment than that of the heartworm. Clear to everyone? So they have less segment body. Okay?
Their bodies are bilaterally symmetrical and less segmented.
Clear to everyone? Now look towards their embryonic development structure. They have three germ layer at their embryonic stage. One is ectoderm, inner is endoderm, middle is mesoderm. And from mesoderm you can see here that body cavity is present. Yes or no? Is it clear to everyone? Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now say in advance whether they will possess the circulatory system and respiratory system or not. Say.
Sir, they will possess.
Yes, very good. Because they are somehow much more developed than that of the annelids. Look at here.
Mollusks are triploblastic animals.
Yes, because they have three germ layers and they are triploblastic in nature.
With a reduced coelomic cavity.
Okay. And they have the reduced coelomic cavity, remember. Reduced means the coelomic cavity is gradually decreasing. You will see their body, they have this reduced coelomic cavity, means reduced body cavity they possess. Okay. And why? Look at, sir, because the circulatory system is developing in this case. the cilium is gradually decreasing its role to contain body fluid. Gradually they are developing the heart like structure, some pipe like structure. So why they will need another vacuole or another body space to hold the body fluid? Okay, now especially they are developing the circulatory system, hence they are reducing the body cavity. Look at here how.
Water mollusks breathe through gills.
Now look, the respiratory system, it is now developing much more. The mollusk which live on water, they can respire through the gills. That means gills are also developing in case of such animals. Previously you have the spiracles and the windpipe or your tracheal system, and now the water molecules, those are aquatic, they can respire through the gills, and those are terrestrial, they can respire through the long life structure. Look at your thin skin also.
While land mollusks have lungs.
You can see the mollusks which live on land. You can see the snail. Some snails are living under water and some snails are living in what? In your wall. Or some damp area. Okay. And they can respire through the lungs. You can see lung is present for you.
And their circulatory systems are open.
And still they have the open circulatory system. Means the blood is not moving through the blood vessel. It is remaining filled with the body cavity. Okay. It is reaching to each and every part of the cell openly. It doesn't need any special blood vessel. Means blood pipe to carry the blood. So they are, hence they are what? They have the
excretion
open circulatory
in
system.
The mollusca phylum is carried out by kidney-like organs.
And now they are developing the third type of physiological system. This is what? Excretory system. Dear to everyone, excretory system is comprised of your kidney, ureter, urinary bladder. So now they are developing a third physiological system, that is the excretory system. Now remember, they have already two physiological system. One is the circulatory system and another is the respiratory system, and they are respiring through the gills when they are remaining under water, and they can respire through the lungs when they remain on soil or land. Another, additionally, they have excretory system which comprises of kidney. Okay, is that clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now look towards the echinodermata of invertebrate phylum, and what is it? Who can say?
Starfish.
Very good. Now
starfish.
Let us see the characteristics of starfish. And look at here, echinodermata comes from two Greek words. One is echinos and dermata. Dermata means dermata comes from the Greek word derma, that means heads of skin. Derma means skin. Okay, and echinos means heads of body. Okay, look towards
echinodermata are spiny skinned organisms and get their name from the Greek word echinos, meaning protective spines.
Look at the heads of, why? Because their outer body structure is somehow looking different, that it can protect their body from the predators. Additionally, they have different spine like structure, pin like structure upon their body. Okay, could you understand?
Yes sir.
Normally simply you can remember echinodermata comes from two word. One is echino, comes from the Greek word echinos, that means protective spines, means their body is covering with spine. And dermata comes from the Greek word
meaning skin.
Skin. Okay.
The phylum echinodermata includes starfish, sea cucumbers, and sea urchins.
Echinoderms
are exclusively free living and they are marine animals.
Look at here the special characteristics. They are aquatic, but they are majorly found in where? In marine condition. Okay, and they are what? free living means they do not depend upon any other organism.
Sir, marine condition means
sea water condition. Okay. They are aquatic, but they are not fresh water living. They are marine water living. Okay.
The skeletons of echinoderms are made of hard calcium carbonate.
And their skeleton means their outer body skeleton is made up of hard calcium carbonate. Okay. And that will develop the hard spin upon their body.
Echinoderms are radially symmetric.
And this one is the exception of all the previous phylum which are remaining under, which are coming after Coelenterata. After Coelenterata, we have seen that all the animals, they have bilateral symmetrical body. And now you can see that these animals, they have radial symmetrical body. Because if you split them into two half, you cannot see each part are equal to another part. Each part is not symmetric to another part. But if you split them in radius wise, you can see that each radial part is symmetrical to another radial part. Hence, this type of body is called as a radially symmetrical body. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, their bodies have three
now
layers.
Now look again that they are also triploblastic because during their embryonic development, you can see they have three germ layers: outer ectoderm, inner endoderm, and in between this derm you have mesoderm. And additionally, mesoderm splits to develop coelom, means body cavity. Is it clear to everyone? And hence they are also called as coelomate. They are triploblastic and coelomate. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
These have three layers called triploblastic, and they have a true coelomic cavity.
You can see their coelom is present at here.
Their bodies have tube-like extensions called
tube feet. Yes, they have the tube-like extensions which are present, and that helps in their locomotion, which is called as tube feet. That means by the help of tube feet, they can move. They have soccer-like structure. Okay, they can attach upon the substratum upon which they can crawl. They can move.
Which
okay.
help in locomotion and food collection. Protochordata belong to the phylum Chordata and are primitive chordates.
That's all about your what? All the invertebrates. We have already completed the invertebrates, and we will in the next class we will discuss much more about the vertebrate. But intermediate to the invertebrate and the vertebrate, the phylums are there. If it possible, then we will discuss later on. Okay, so for today only this much, and get ready for the next class. Okay.